Hey guys, it's Tony again with Backwoods Biker Magazine. It's March and it's time to show you the March knife of the month. Hang tight. All right guys, welcome back. Listen, we have got another great offering from Grayman Knives out in California. You know, we had requests for some bigger knives, and I got to tell you that you know, last year's submission from Grayman was the MP Boy, and it was nominated for Knife of the Year. Really, super outstanding knife. And just when you think, you know, Grayman doesn't have anything on the larger size other than something like that, and the pounder that he has, the ground pounder. I got to tell you, this right here is called the Darfur Defender. And he names a lot of his knives from the Sudan, from areas in the Sudan where he was an operator and did a lot of work there. And as I told you before, when you look at one of his knives, you can tell that this guy was an operator, and he's been in situations where knives were important to him. And one look at this knife here, and you can tell this big old booger is ready to do some work. Let me tell you a little bit about this knife. As a matter of fact, I brought down this piece of paper, and I'm just going to read it from you. I don't mind reading it. It says this, this Darfur Defender was hand ground from 154 cm steel. That's from Crucible, by the way, boutique steel. It's a little over a quarter inch thick, has a 7.5 inch blade, and is 13.5 inches overall. Comes with either black or green G10 scales, and it includes free personalized hand graving on the spine in a Kadura sheath, and it's double beveled. A lot of his knives come single bevel. This happens to be one that is double bevel. Now, at 20 ounces here in your hand, you know, I mean, there are 16 ounces to a pound, so it's 1 pound, 4 ounces. It has some heft, it has some weight, and I tell you, you whack something or someone with this knife, and it is going to do some hefty damage. It's over a quarter inch boutique steel. This CPM 154 CPM or CPM steel is very, very expensive, first of all, but it is a tried and true. It's very highly proven steel. A lot of guys like this, especially if they're going to be around water, salt water. These knives will really stave off any type of corrosion, or at least minimize it a whole lot. But the particulars of this knife, you know, I mean, when you look down the blade at this thing, it's a full tang knife at 13.5 inches. I mean, that's a humdinger, but look at the shape on that tip, would you? That is really, really cool. But I mean, it's stout. I didn't take this out a whole lot myself personally. Rocky did, and Rocky's been carrying it on his side for like 3 months, ever since the day that it arrived, and this has grown into his favorite knife. But he tells me that, and by the way, he's getting an article together for March, because this is the knife of the month for March. But he tells me that this thing will chop, it will baton, it will do fine tasks, and that is important to me and to a lot of guys that want to use a bigger knife, because when you get a bigger knife, you know, those finer tasks are often very difficult to do. But if you can see how Grayman does the finger chull and this ramp, it's not a jimped ramp, but it's what I call a trigger ramp. It reminds you of a trigger on a pistol. And the way that it's set up, you can get a lot of control off of this big old knife. Now, I don't know if you can see that or not, but I'm feathering this piece of fat wood right out of there. Look at that. I mean, right on down. Gee, that is very, very fine. But it does the heavy tasks, obviously. I mean, it's going to chop down, you know, 3 and 4 inch trees without a problem. It's that heavy. But being heavy, because of the fact that it is balanced so well, is not a negative factor with this knife. A lot of knives are this hefty. It's terrible. It's terrible to try to keep these in your hand. But on his website, one of the things that he has to say is that if you happen to be practiced in the Filipino or the Bui style of knife fighting, this is a great knife for that particular art, because it provides easy recovery because of that balance and the forward weight that's to this. You know, there's not a lot of weight that provides stress. A lot of big knives will provide stress right here in the forearm and in the elbow. You don't get that with this knife, you know. And not only does it have these big knife features to it, but it's got these nice G10 scales. Look at the lanyard hole on the end of that huge pommel that's sticking out there. And you know, I like pommels in all my knives, all my belt knives that I carry around with me, because I want to use it to be able to crush things, whether it's crush a nut, it is to process wood. If I'm going to do some napping, you know, with the butt of my knife, the pommel of my knife, and this big old booger right here could do the job. Man, I don't care what you're cracking, whether it's a coconut or a skull, it's going to do the job for you. And, you know, I've had a lot of people, you know, send me some negative emails because I talk about these knives in that way. But listen, as I've told you from the beginning, Mike from Grayman Knives is a former operator. He had to learn to use knives like this in tactical situations. This is a great tactical knife. It's a great survival knife. You know, if you're looking for something small and dainty, turn the page, brother, because this ain't it for you. But if you're one of those that wants a larger knife to take out of the bush with you, or if you're getting ready to be deployed, you know, if it was me, I'd want to take something like this. Now, as far as wearing this knife, it comes with a Kodura sheath with a nylon insert, okay? And all of his knives that I've seen so far come this way, except his folders. But if I were to take this knife with me, I would put it on the shoulder strap of my backpack, because that's where I like to have my larger knives and deploy them quickly. I don't care for them on my side as much. I want something kind of a medium type of knife. But boy, oh boy, you talk about a knife that is beautiful, is very, very practical. And the price on this only starts at $255. They also come in 1095 steel, I believe. But all you got to do is get on the website there at www.graymanknives.com. They'll email you. They're great communicators. But don't even try to call them, because there's no phone numbers. Mike does no phone calls at all. I've been dealing with him for all over a year and a half. I've never spoke to him on the phone at all. You know, it's all about the email thing. But they're great about it, and they'll answer any questions you got. And they've got a great website full of information also. So now, you keep an eye out on our website at backwoodsbiker.com, because there's going to be a full article in the March issue on the knife of the month, and the details that I haven't given you here, there's going to be a lot more details, and the narrative on this knife will interest you. We also have the folder of the month. I'm not even going to tell you what that is, but we got another folder that we're going to feature. Last month, it was the Grayman Tiga. What a knife. As a matter of fact, nope, it's not in my pocket here. I took it out, it's on my desk. But I've been carrying that around ever since the day I got it, because it is a humdinger of a knife. So you want to see the video on that, and you'll want to read the article on that. We just launched that magazine, the February issue. Go to backwoodsbiker.com, hit that tab up there that says magazine, it'll drop down, you hit current issue, and there you go. You can read it in its entirety. Now, just a little bit of a reveal for you here. In the next couple of months, we're no longer going to offer that online magazine for free. But don't fret, we're going to have a totally different website, and on that website, you can become a subscriber for only $1 a month. And that gives you all the access to every article every piece of gear that we review, that we recommend, all the celebrity guests that we have on board. You know, this year we've got Craig Cottle lined up. We've got Les Stroud lined up. We just did a full feature on Brian Stevens from Survival on Purpose. We've got a lot of guys out there that you've been asking us to get in the magazine, and so we're doing it for you. So things are really looking up, and it's because of your help and your support. All you people reading that magazine online, you know, I forget what the number is now, but it's, you know, it's over 20,000, you know, that's peaking at that magazine, and it's growing on a weekly basis, so we appreciate that. So, listen, thank you very much for all your support and all your help, as always. If you want to be a subscriber, if you want to be entered in to win things like this folder and this Smith's Pocket Pal, that's what we gave away in February, getting ready to notify those winners. That email down there, just email us and say, I'm a subscriber. That's all you got to do, and then you're put in the database, and every month we do a random drawing out of that, and you might get some free gear. You do have to pay for the postage. You know, we're giving you the free gear, but if you want it, you got to pay the postage. That's all there is to it, because somebody has to pay it, you know, and we used to. We just can't afford to do it anymore. I'm sure you can understand. So, listen, thank you for watching. And as always, you ride free, you live free, and when you're hell alive, you be safe out there.